You haven't seen this yet. You need to see Randy Orton completely, in my opinion, this is great storytelling. Just completely what a viper would do if it had legs. It would jump up, touch the toes with the fingers, shadow box a little bit.
I like that the description for the video says Randy Orton goes crazy after RKO on Mark Henry. Like, that's exactly...
I think it was an uncontrollable impulse that comes with having his new beard. Like, people with that beard have to shadow box and do jumping splits with underwear on. All right, so far... what? He's already going crazy. Watch. What? What was that? All right.
I was impressed.
Now, Danny Richardson, here's my main problem. I'm going back. Before he even hits it, he's doing a fucking foot shuffle like he's fighting Marvin Hagler. Look, he's... here we go. Oh, man. Stop it. Look, wait. All right, paused again. I'm going back. First of all, look at look at the referee. The referee's like, this is what the referee's...
I think on the same frame I am, where he's leaning back. He's almost going into like full Matrix pose there.
It looks like he's about to start like pulling his teeth out of his head, shaving his hair off. Like, he's melting. That was insane. He just loves it. Christian just staring at Mark Henry. All right,
can't believe what I just saw.
We need to focus on not the 12-year-olds that love it, but the Little Nate. Let's watch the Little Nate, the referee, all the way through. Oh, what a kick. Oh, my God. He can't believe it. Oh, whoa, in a flip. And then Christian...
The ref with his back to the ropes is just blown away by what he saw.
And Christian was just scratching his head. Again, one more time. Something that better not ever happen again in real life. We're about to watch for the fifth time. Watch Christian now. All right, kick. What an RKO. And then, okay, well, this is weird. He's scratching. I don't know.
And even his shadow boxing was awkward as he punched upward rather than just jabs.
That, for the first time, a wrestler looked like a jock to me. Like, I know they're supposed to be the bullies growing up in high school. They're the strong kids. They're the jocks. But I always had a disconnect. Like, maybe a geek like one of my friends could have grown up and been a wrestler. Jeff Jarrett is a good example. But now I see Randy Orton was captain of the football team, doing split jumps and beating the fuck out of me and my friends. And now I can't buy him as a face.
That toe touch may have ruined the way I see Randy Orton forever. That has to be one of the daintiest, unintentionally daintiest things I've ever seen done in a wrestling ring.
I gotta see it again. It's like, it's as almost as if he hates Mark Henry as much as I do. He's hoping that maybe there's a botch here, maybe a neck goes a certain way, and he just really thought it happened. What the fuck? What is this, fucking the Harlem Globetrotters? Oh,
now,
no.
Is this the end of SmackDown? Is this how it ended there?
That's the end. We're left with that sour taste in our mouth at the end of fucking SmackDown.